All right. I think we're ready to record. Test, test, test. There we go.
Hello, Flunk. Hey, listen.
On episode 443 of Nintendo Switchcraft, Super Nintendo Controllers in January, The Dark Crystal in February, and Alien Isolation right now. Those stories and more on this episode of Nintendo Switchcraft.
This is Joel Mead 24 from Southern California, and you're listening to Bill, the filthiest casual in all of gaming, here on Nintendo Switchcraft.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Switchcraft. It's brought to you live every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. You can tune in live at twitch.tv/runjumpstomp. And you can also thank the patrons for helping make this episode possible. This particular episode of Switchcraft is made possible by patrons like Brian R. Get Switchcraft and my other content ad-free for as little as a dollar by joining the Patreon over at patreon.com/runjumpstomp. And if you want to leave a voicemail like you heard at the top of the show, that's easy to do as well. Join us over at runjumpstomp.com/voicemail from any device. Leave a message, and I may even play it on the show. That being said, let's jump right into the first story of the day. And the first story that we're going to talk about today is the Super Nintendo controller that goes with the Nintendo Switch is now officially sold out until January 2020. Now, if you don't know what I'm talking about, Nintendo has a... Okay, if you're listening to the audio show, then you just you'd probably know what I'm talking about anyway. But if you're watching on YouTube, this is the NES controller that slides onto the side of the Nintendo Switch, and it pairs with the Nintendo Switch so you can play old NES games on it. It's fantastic. It works really well. It feels really good. The overall build quality is fantastic. And I'm really happy that I bought them. You bought it when the NES stuff came out, and it came with two. It's really cool. Now, later on, when Nintendo finally released the Super Nintendo games on Nintendo Switch, which I talked about a few episodes back. You can go back and check that out. They also announced Super Nintendo controllers that are very much like this, except for they don't slide onto the side of your Nintendo Switch like that. They charge via a cord, which is fine. Those are now sold out until January 2020. And I know that there's going to be a lot of people who say, listen, I really want to get this because I want to have an authentic experience when playing these Super Nintendo games, and I feel like I missed out, and I can understand that. I definitely can. Here's what the article from Silicon Era says. It says, Nintendo Switch Online subscribers, and by the way, in order to buy these, you do have to be a Nintendo Switch Online subscriber, but subscribers hoping to get exclusive Switch Super Nintendo controllers before 2019 finishes up will be disappointed. The accessory is sold out. Both the North American and European product listings note as out of stock, with the former saying more information will arrive in January 2020. This comes to us from a tweet from Wario64. By the way, if you don't already follow Wario64, you absolutely should. Wario64 is a Twitter account that tweets out really, really good deals. So even if you're not a Twitter user, get on Twitter, make an account, make sure you pick a profile, just any picture will do. Normally if you make an account on Twitter and you don't make an account, it leaves you as an egg. And that's one of the things that Twitter will decide if you're a robot account or not, and they may delete your account. So make sure that you make an account, give yourself an image, and follow at Wario64 for the most up-to-date deals that you can get. Some people think that Wario64 is a bot, and I'm not sure, probably, But sometimes it makes me think not, like, I think it's definitely a bot is getting the information, but then a person is tweeting it out sometimes, or maybe multiple people are tweeting it out because it's all the time. Anyway, this is where this information originally came from, is Wario64. So follow them on Twitter. And while you're at it, follow me on Twitter at RunJumpStomp. But the January 2020 window is only noted on the North American product page. On the European listing, it says this product is currently unavailable. More stock will be arriving in early 2020, so please stay tuned for further updates. Now, as I said, I understand why people would want to have these controllers to play the Super Nintendo games on. I understand that. 100%, it's great. Okay? That being said, I think that you would do better to buy something else. And that something else is just out of reach, so I have to reach over and grab one. And that is my favorite Nintendo Switch controller. And a lot of people who've paid attention to my content before, they know what's coming. It's the 8-bit Do SN30 Pro Plus. This is the perfect controller to have. It feels like a Super Nintendo controller mixed with a Nintendo Switch Pro controller, and a PlayStation DualShock 4. That's what it feels like. It's got a great battery life. It's incredibly comfortable. The D-pad, in my opinion, is fantastic. And again, this looks just like a Super Nintendo controller. The only difference is it has two joysticks and it has these wings, which make it even easier to hold on to. Now, the price for the Super Nintendo controllers, honestly, I can't remember exactly how much it was. Let me click on this link again, because I didn't plan on talking about this. It's $30 for one controller. All right, so $30, and that will get you a single Super Nintendo Entertainment System controller. If you go to 8BitDo's website, you can buy the SN30 Pro Plus for more money. Without a doubt, it does cost more to buy a SN30 Pro Plus. And I'm going to find out exactly how much this costs. Whoops, that's the wrong button. It's $49.99. So yes, this does cost more than the $30, but I think that is money well spent, because you can use this controller for way more than you can the other controller. It has rumble, it has gyro, it has thumbsticks. It doesn't have HD rumble, so there's definitely a downside there, but it's also completely configurable via plugging in a USB-C cord into it and then hooking it up to your computer, downloading their software, and then you can reconfigure exactly how sensitive the triggers are, how sensitive the joysticks are. You can customize it to your liking. You can even swap buttons around if you want. This is a much better deal than getting those Super Nintendo controllers, which are definitely authentic. Without a doubt, they feel authentic, I'm sure, because I have the Super Nintendo Classic, and it came with Super Nintendo controllers, and I am 99.9% sure that they used exactly the same hardware for that they did for this. Just this one is wireless with Bluetooth in it. But I think that this is a much better option for anybody out there looking to play Super Nintendo games, but also wanting to play other games. And yes, it's a little bit more money, but honestly, you're going to be happy that you went with this instead of the less expensive but also much less capable controllers that are the Super Nintendo controllers. And so that's my advice to you. Let me know what you guys think. What are your favorite controllers on Nintendo Switch? I'm very curious as to what everybody else thinks about their favorite controllers. For me, hands down, without a doubt, the 8-bit Do SN30 Pro Plus. And let me know if you're watching this on YouTube. Leave a comment down below. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe and all that stuff, and click the bell. And if you are listening to this on the podcast, then you can email me, runjumpstomp@gmail.com, or you can get a hold of me on Twitter at runjumpstomp. All right, let's move on. The next story that I want to talk about today is The Dark Crystal. The Dark Crystal, one of my favorite movies of all time. I absolutely love The Dark Crystal. It's fantastic. And it is a game that's been coming. Now, we heard about this. We heard about it a while ago. I'm not sure how long ago, and I don't know why I'm opening this this up again because I already have it opened. There we go. We heard about this. I think it was at E3. And when I saw it, I was like, oh my God, this looks fantastic. It's basically what it's reminiscent of Final Fantasy Tactics or Fire Emblem, you know, that kind of turn-based top, like, not necessarily top-down, but three-quarters perspective strategy game in the Dark Crystal universe. And I was really surprised when they said that this was coming out later in 2019 because, you know, the show, they recently did a show, I think, I haven't watched it yet, which is just like my wife and I have so many things that we're trying to watch, we can't possibly keep up with them all. But I haven't watched it yet, and it looks really, really good. Like, I'm very excited to check it out, and I've heard very, very good things about it. But it came to Netflix. I think it's like either a prequel or a sequel to what was happening in the movie. And this is supposed to be kind of like a movie, even though it's a TV show, a movie tie-in game. Remember back in the 90s when we had movie tie-in games all the time? And most of the time, they were pretty bad. Now, this is not the first movie tie-in game. And I keep saying movie, but it's TV show. I know. This is not the first tie-in game that Netflix has released. They also released Stranger Things Season 3, The Game, which was this, how do I want to say? It was more like an RPG, like an action RPG. Not like Diablo, but not a turn-based RPG either. And it was very pixelated kind of art style. It looked cool. It had great music, of course, because it's Stranger Things, and that's like one of the greatest theme songs of all time. But it really kind of captured the spirit of the show in a way. It was very low level and very repetitive, but it was also fun, and I enjoyed what I did play of it. My son really jumped in a lot on that game because that's like his favorite show of all time. And that kind of made me excited for the Dark Crystal game, Dark Crystal Tactics. Actually, that's not the name of the game. It's called The Dark Crystal Age of Resistance Tactics, just so everybody knows. Well, that was supposed to come out in 2019 alongside the show, but it didn't launch with the show. And I was very surprised by that. But once you miss that launch window, it really doesn't matter. You take as much time as you need. And apparently they need more time. It was supposed to make it was originally targeted for 2019 to be released. And apparently, according to Engadget, John Fingus over at Engadget, it's not coming until February 4th, 2020. So we've got a little bit longer to wait before we get to play that game. Now, I think that that's totally fine. Honestly, I probably wouldn't have played it yet anyway because I'm just swamped right now. I've got a bunch of games to play. I still haven't finished Luigi's Mansion. I know. Don't at me. Or, you know what? At me. That's fine too. But I still haven't finished Luigi's Mansion 3. I've got a lot of stuff to play, and I'm glad that this is being pushed off until later on. It comes out on the PS4, the Switch, the Xbox One, Mac, and PC, and you are playing through the and beyond the story of the show. So you play through the show, and you play beyond the show. And I think that this is good for me that it's not out yet, because maybe by February 4th, 2020, I will have actually finished the, or maybe started watching the show, and then I'll be able to play through the game without being spoiled on the show, if that makes any sense. Overall, I think that it looks really, really fun. I love the art style of it, And I'm excited for it. And it's too bad that it got delayed, but, you know, at the end of the day, if a game gets delayed, it's for a good reason. It's because it needs to get delayed. So anyway, let's talk about one of my favorite games of all time. First, I'm going to take a break. And thank a sponsor. When I come back, I'm going to talk about one of my favorite games of all time that I have talked about many times on this show already. And some of you already know what it is. Stick around.
Oh, Pac-Man, I'm beat.
And I'm hungry.
Thank goodness for Pac-Man pasta from Chef Boyardee.
All right, we're back. Thank you very much to our sponsors. Alien Isolation, I've talked about it a bunch. It's out now on the Nintendo Switch. And this is very, very surprising to me. This actually kind of blew me away. And I had to do a little bit of digging to find out why this might be. But Digital Foundry, and if you don't know who Digital Foundry is, they have a fantastic YouTube channel where they analyze, what's the word I'm looking for? They take a look at footage from games and they figure out what resolution is this running in? What frames per second is this running in? They analyze the heck out of a game. They get into the nitty gritty stuff. And they put out a 20-minute video about Alien Isolation on the Switch. And they talk about how this game is actually better looking on the Nintendo Switch than it was on the PS4. Now, you might wonder, why would that be? And I'm not sure why they're showing footage from other games right now. Let me skip forward to Alien Isolation stuff. Why would that be? Well, the Switch has been out for nearly 3 years now. Has it been? Yeah, it'll be 3 years in March. So 3 years in March. It's been almost 3 years that the Nintendo Switch has been out. And why would it look better on Switch than on PlayStation, on PS4, which is a much, much more powerful system? Well, here's the reason. It was a port to the PS4. Like, it originally did not come out on the PS4. That was not the release game. It was a port to PS4. And when it came to PS4, when they made the game for PS4, even if it wasn't a port, when they made the game for PS4, the developers were new at working with the PS4, and they just didn't know how hard they could push the hardware. They didn't know how awesome the hardware, they didn't know what the hardware could do. They didn't know the tricks and workarounds in order to get the most out of the PS4. Because the PS4 was very, very new when they started bringing this game over. However, with the Nintendo Switch, developers have had lots of time to work on bringing, porting games over to the Nintendo Switch. And because of that, they've learned all of the tips and tricks of working with this Nintendo hardware in order to make things run really, really well. Now, of course, loading takes longer on the Nintendo Switch, but that's fine. You get actually improved quality on the Nintendo Switch over the PS4. And I think that that is very, very interesting. Now, the whole video is nearly 20 minutes long, so I'm obviously not going to talk about the whole thing. You should definitely follow the link in the show notes. Go to runjumpstomp.com. This is episode 443. Follow the link in the show notes, and you can watch the video for yourself and understand how they got it all running. And I've said on the show many times, if you can get Alien Isolation someplace else, get it someplace else, because it's not going to look as good on the Switch as it will on other platforms because the Switch is less powerful. Turns out I was wrong. This is the best place to play Alien Isolation right now. Well, okay. If you've got a computer, then play it on the computer. All right. When you're comparing the consoles, the Xbox, the PlayStation, the Nintendo Switch, it seems as if the Nintendo Switch is the best place to get Alien Isolation. Of course, you can get it much, much cheaper on Steam than you can on any of the consoles. But Alien Isolation, one of my favorite games of all time, super scary, incredibly awesome story, in my opinion. And there are some surprises that happen throughout the game that are just fantastic, as well as some wonderful jump scares. If you like to be scared, this is a game for you. And apparently, getting it on the Switch is the right move. Now, somebody would ask, Bill, are you going to get it on the Nintendo Switch? And I don't think that I am. And it's not because I already own it twice. I have it on PlayStation. I have it on PC. I already own it twice. I don't need to buy it again. In fact, you might say, well, Bill, why did you buy it the second time? Well, I bought it the second time because I just don't like playing games on my PC anymore. I broke my arm a few years ago, and twisting my arm into WASD is kind of painful. So I just prefer to play games on my consoles these days. So a lot of the stuff that I have on PC that I'm actually really like playing, I've bought multiple times. I bought it on my consoles as well, because that allows me to play in a more comfortable setting, you know, with a controller in my hand where I don't have to twist my left arm into this really normal but painful for me position. Anyway, now you know, and no one's half the battle. Let's move on. Stealth. I actually have had him, I interviewed him once before on the show, and he's a Twitter user who tweets out a bunch of stuff. He's at Stealth40K. He basically tweets out his thoughts on video games, as well as does giveaways and stuff like that. He tweeted this out today. He got it from theconsoleclub.gr, which is a German website. And thank you to him for translating for me. But he said that it appears that Dragon Quest Heroes 1 and 2 for Nintendo Switch is releasing in the West after all this time. The version of the game not only contained additional content on top of the PS4 versions of these games, but it includes all of the DLC as well. Now, this is a leak. This is not official. Like, this has not been posted by Square Enix anywhere. This is a leak coming from a website. And this is the same retailer that did leak Assassin's Creed, the Rebel Collection for Nintendo Switch before the most recent Nintendo Direct. So that's something that you have to keep in mind. Overall, why do people care about this? Well, Dragon Quest is huge. It's absolutely huge. And with Dragon Quest XI S Echoes of an Elusive Age plus Go Smash Ultimate, whatever they called that game, with that doing so well, of course Square is going to double down on the Dragon Quest name and bring more stuff over here. I mean, look at how well Dragon Quest Builders 2 is doing. So Square Enix, you know, they're definitely known for seeing where the wind is blowing, or reading the tea leaves, and, you know, bringing products to us that a lot of people want. All right, last thing before we get to feedback is there is a first anniversary, and I keep opening these tabs twice. There's a first anniversary spirit event for Super Smash Brothers. If you didn't know, Super Smash Brothers came out about a year ago. And it's had a fantastic year. It's the best-selling fighting game of all time. And on December 6th, in Smash Ultimate, there is the first anniversary spirit event, which is coming to Smash. It says, this is tweeted out by @SmashBrosJP, so Japan. So this is official. It says, Nintendo has announced the next spirit event coming to Smash Brothers Ultimate starting in December 6th. This time, the event is to celebrate the first anniversary of Smash Ultimate's release. During this event, all experience points and SP earned from battle will be tripled, and the 50% damage item will be included in rewards. The event begins Friday and will last for 3 days. I don't really care about spirit modes. I know that it's this thing that a lot of people like because of, you know, it gives you single-player stuff to do. Once I unlocked all the characters, I don't think I've played any single player since, except for maybe like when a new character comes out, I'll load into like a training session just so I can figure out how their moves work. But other than that, when I play Smash, it's to play online. It's cool that Nintendo is supporting it, but this I just don't care about. That being said, I know that there's a lot of Smash fans out there, and a lot of them will care about this, so I wanted to make sure that I told everybody because you know what? It's not all about me. Sometimes it's about you guys as well. All right, let's wrap up the show. And I just closed my show notes, so I'm going to have to do this on the fly. And you could see me furiously trying to open up the right windows. become a part of the community by joining our Discord over at runjumpstomp.com/Discord. There's almost 900 people over there. It would be amazing if you guys could come and hang out with us. I also would like to ask you to check out one of my other shows, 143 Pixels. Those episodes come out on Tuesday. We're about, okay, I don't know where we are. I know that I've already uploaded all of December's stuff, and I can't remember how many episodes in we are, but I just released an episode where I talked to the Nintendo guru, Bobby Pauls, and he and I talked about The Last of Us 2, and we had an absolute great conversation that I hope that you guys will check out. I'm really excited for 143 Pixels, and I hope that more people will check it out. If you want to check it out, go to either runjumpstomp.com/shows, or you can just search for it in whatever podcast device that you're listening to this on right now, or you can go to anchor.fm/143. That's anchor.fm/143, and it has all of the appropriate things, you know, all the places that you would subscribe to it right there on the webpage, anchor.fm/143. Please consider subscribing to that podcast. This show is part of the Giant Sized Team Up Network. For more information about the Giant Sized Team Up Network, join us over at gstu.net. And if you want to support the show, go to runjumpstomp.com/thank you. The music that you are hearing right now is Corneria Star Fox Remix by Noteblock. I will see you all next time. Until then, stay awesome. Bye-bye.